بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم وبعد April 1st known as April Fool's Day. In case we didn't know the origins of this day, the history of this day, according to some, this probably originated in France. And when the Council of Trent, they had called for the Julian calendar to be changed to the Gregorian calendar. They had called for this in 1563, and this hadn't taken place until approximately 1582, if I'm not mistaken. So what had happened is they had decided that they were going to change the beginning of the new year to January 1st from the spring equinox, which was on April 1st, the end of March, basically. So those people, after it was already changed, those who were late to find out, they were called April Fools, the Fools of April, because they were a little late to find out that it's already been changed. It's no longer the end of March that marks the beginning of the new year. It's the beginning of January. This went on and on, and it became something so big until finally, unfortunately, today, this is still being practiced, though not on a large scale in terms of, you know, it's not so much materialistic, or it's not commercialized, but it is still being practiced. It might seem like a joke, literally like a joke, no pun intended, but it is being practiced. As for us, the Muslims, we've got nothing to do with April Fools. Lying is a sign of a munafiq, a hypocrite. The Prophet ﷺ said, Ayatul munafiqi thalathatun idha haddatha kathaba. One of the signs of a munafiq is that when he speaks, he lies. So we're not allowed to lie, and especially not as a joke either. The Prophet ﷺ said, Waylul lilladhi yuhadithu bilhadithi liyudhika bihil qawm fayakthib. Waylul lahu, waylul lahu. May that person be cursed. May that person be destroyed. Destruction to that person who tells a story to a people and he lies to make them laugh. In order to entertain the people, he has to lie to get these people to laugh. He just wants to have a good time, and so he decides to lie. The Prophet ﷺ cursed him three times. Waylul lahu, waylul lahu. We're not allowed to lie, period. That's the bottom line. You know, a woman, Abdullah bin Amr radiallahu anhu, says, my mother called me while Rasulullah ﷺ was at my house, and he said, come here. My mother said to me, come here, I'll give you something. So the Prophet ﷺ asked my mother, were you really intending on giving him something, or were you just trying to prank him, play a joke with him? She said, no, I was actually going to give him a date. The Prophet ﷺ said, good, because if you had not intended to give him anything, you would have been lying. You would have been responsible for a lie. So this is not a joke, and there is no joke. This concept of frightening someone, the Prophet ﷺ said, لَا يَحِلُّ لِمُسْلِمٍ أَن يُرَوِّعَ مُسْلِمًا. You're not allowed. It's not permissible for a believer to scare, to frighten, to play a prank on anybody on anybody else. So there's no lying. There's no lying in jest as a joke. There's no pranking. There's no frightening. There's no scaring. May Allah give us the understanding.